You might not be able to see it, but the financial system, as we know it, is changing. The way we make money, send money, save money, even how we pay for things. It's all shifting thanks to a new form of technology that in just a decade has gone from niche to mainstream.
We're going to talk about cryptocurrency.
Something called the Bitcoin.
AKA digital gold.
One in five Australians now own cryptocurrency. It's been described as this generation's gold rush. But what does that mean for the rest of us? Over the next few weeks, I'm going to try and understand what the world of cryptocurrency is, what it does, and most importantly, whether it's really time to buy in. If there is anything that could convince me that crypto is a good investment, it's got to be this.
Money, 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 all the time, what I'm thinking about. It's on my mind all the time, all I think about. Pull up in a whip, new drip, what's your bank account? Hop about the drop, stop, what's your bank account? Money out the sunroof.
Welcome to the Crypto Castle.
So this is the house, the crypto board.
It's the one.
All right, wow.
You lead the way. Come on in.
Fred Chibesta is co-founder and CEO of comparison website finder.com, but he's also started a cryptocurrency brokerage and wants to set up Australia's first crypto bank.
We're in the dawning of the internet again, but it's just in a slightly different market. The internet was about media and communication.
Well, it's very hip to be on the internet right now.
This is about finance and money.
So how big is the cryptocurrency world?
Well, it's massive. You know, there's probably 6,500 plus coins.
What are the sorts of things that you see cryptocurrencies being used for?
You can store your wealth with something like Bitcoin. You can trade currency. You can pay other people. You can play games and earn money. All the smart and incredible builders and creators are coming into crypto. They're going to do something.
It feels like crypto is close to ready for the mainstream.
There's a big industry around Bitcoin.
Prices have been soaring for cryptos like Bitcoin, Ethereum, especially Dogecoin.
There are people out there that look at cryptocurrency and go, it's too risky. I don't think people should be investing in it. What do you say to people like that?
So like right now, what are your options as a retail investor to go and invest your money? What actually can you do to get some higher returns than put it in the bank? We're getting, what, 0.25% in our bank accounts? So you go back 10 years. It was very hard for a retail investor to get access to anything risky. All the investment bankers, the hedge funds, they had access. No one got offered Google stock or Facebook stock when it IPO'd. No one. Whereas now with cryptocurrency, you can go and buy an extremely risky thing and potentially, yeah, it'll go to zero, but it also could be the next Facebook or Google. With great risk comes potential for great return.
That's the thing about crypto now. It's not just about tech bros with flash houses. Investors now come from all walks of life.
You want three in there?
Yeah, three.
I usually have one, don't I?
Wait. I had a friend who introduced me to crypto. He was starting to get involved. And I remember asking him if it was even legal.
This is Anita. She's a single mum living in a small town.
I have two children, Archer and Willow, and they're about to turn 11 and 9. And financially, I'm pretty much doing it on my own with them as well.
Can you grab the two bags? How are you going, Willow? Do you want to grab your bag, darling?
Anita doesn't have a lot of spare time, but in between parenting and her day job, she's also building her crypto portfolio.
So I didn't buy straight away. I started to learn technical analysis, which is learning the charts. And I started doing that early 2020. I invested in Bitcoin and I remember pushing the button for the first time and just taking a deep breath.
That's right, Bubbleland.
I started with $15,000 and invested that. And within 18 months, it's about $50,000. Well done. It's funny, I said to my friend who introduced me to crypto right back at the start, I said, I don't want to look rich. I don't want people to look at me and think that's what I'm doing or that I've got money. For me, it's about the freedom. Took the kids on a holiday, and it wasn't a big holiday with aeroplanes or anything fancy, but to be able to go away for them and not be watching how much money I was spending as closely as I normally would have. It just made it far more relaxing to be able to do that. Christmas time's a little bit easier as a single mum. Those sorts of things, it just has given me a bit more space.
If you're wondering about the difference between traditional financial systems and cryptocurrencies, a good way to think about it is like this. So once upon a time, you might have had a piggy bank and it would have had Australian dollars or maybe American dollars or German Deutschmarks, whatever. All of those currencies were created by a government.
But these days, you can have a digital piggy bank with a digital currency in it. These currencies like Bitcoin, Ethereum, Dogecoin or Solana, they're made by people or groups of people. Just like old school money, you can buy and trade these cryptocurrencies. And just like in the old days, there are ledgers recording every transaction. Except now, these ledgers are digital and we call them blockchains. Fred Shibesta says crypto and blockchain technology have already proven that they're here to stay.
It was literally a coin flip here. I remember it so clearly. Everyone thought Bitcoin was done. Everyone thought, oh, it's a scam, let's bail. And then look at this. Look what happened after the pandemic. Yo, wait for this. Oh.
For people like Fred, this is just the beginning. He believes that we are on the cusp of a financial revolution that will give people more control over their wealth.
Traditional financial markets devalue currencies over time. Well, now you have a decentralized money system where the people finally actually control it. Code controls it, not a centralized government. The people own the money.
The thing is, when Bitcoin first launched, many saw it as a bit of a joke. But now, even old financial institutions, the same ones that lots of crypto enthusiasts would rather get away from, well, they want a piece of the action too.
This includes Australia's largest bank.
Which bank?
The Commonwealth Bank of Australia has just become one of the first big banks in the world to offer crypto buying and selling on its app.
You know, we see it as a very volatile and speculative asset, but we also don't think that the sector and the technology is going away anytime soon. We see risks in participating, but we see bigger risks in not participating.
He's talking about the risk of missing out.
With four simple words that have been whispered by the intrepid since the time of the Romans. Fortune favors the brave.
It's crypto exchanges like this, flush with money, that have got the old banks worried. There's any number of these platforms now vying for your investment, promising not only an alternative way to grow your wealth, but also a more empowered future.
Freedom of innovation, freedom of money, freedom of choice. Exchange the world.
All you need to sign up to an exchange is a phone, some ID, and a credit card.
So they're telling me I need to do a selfie, but I'm not allowed to smile. And then there's this verification thing where you have to look at it, get your head in the frame and open your mouth. Oh, that seems to have worked. And now I just have to wait to be verified. That took about 10 minutes. So I'm in and I don't know what any of this means. There's literally a cryptocurrency here called Smooth Love Potion. None of this makes sense to me at all.
I've decided I need somebody to hold my hand through this crypto buying process, and I think I've found the perfect person. Lucinda Price, aka Frooms, is a comedian, a storyteller, an internet sensation, and hopefully my crypto guru.
Hello, Marc Fennell.
Hello.
My name is Frumi, and I'm going to teach you all about crypto. And this is not financial advice.
I've come to Frooms because I know she has her own inspiring crypto story.
I fucking did it!
I have my first BNB coin.
Where does your crypto journey actually begin?
It started in April of last year. I was sitting in bed and I thought, oh, I've got to do something for Instagram. I'm going to throw $500 out there and say to everybody who follows me, how can I double my money? There was this one guy and he was saying you should look into altcoins. They're a really great way to make money really quickly.
Altcoins or alternative coins are any cryptocurrencies other than like the major ones like Bitcoin. And there are thousands of them.
he gave me a list of all different names. And one of them was called Cummies, which is short for Cum Rocket.
Of course.
And I thought, that is funny. That's gross. And this coin was really interesting because it did have a real world use. And that is that you would buy it and then you could use it to pay for adult content and porn.
Mm. My throat is closing over at this point. I'm feeling really not funny about this anymore.
I bought the Cummies and I started posting about it. And then it started going up. And on the first day, it jumps a little bit. Second day, jumps a little bit. Third day, it jumps considerably.
Cummies has just fucking hit.
How is this happening?
Are you just sitting there on your phone, just like refresh, refresh, refresh?
Yeah, I got my phone, I've got my laptop. During it, I had to catch a plane somewhere and not being able to look at it while I was on the plane, I was like, get off the plane. It had gone up to $10,000, you know? This was happening so quickly. And then by the end of the week, it had gone up to, the $500 was worth $14,000. It was amazing.
All right, I think I'm doing it. I think I'm buying some crypto. Obviously, I'm going to get some Bitcoin, most well known. But the thing I got from Froomes is that you invest in those altcoins, some of them can just explode. So here is what I have got. I've just bought something called Reefer Token, which is something to do with medicinal cannabis. There's also one here called No War Token, after seeing everything that's been happening in Ukraine. And there's another one here that's about a virtual porn metaverse because, well, I mean, it's the internet. You have to bet on porn. It always makes money. What's the worst that could happen?
I've got to go.
Wait, before you go, what happened with your Cummies investment?
I lost it all. Bye.
Oh, shit. Rule number one when investing is to make sure you understand something. If you don't understand it, it's not a good investment. Rule number two is that if all your friends are into it and everybody else is into it, then yeah, it's usually a red flag. Be a little bit cautious.
Ugh, what a killjoy. This is Shane Oliver. He has a PhD in economics and is the chief economist at AMP. And he reckons that those who think Bitcoin is too big to fail need a bit of a history lesson.
Look, I'm always worried when people say that something's too big to fail and therefore it won't fail. We have seen through history lots of companies that everybody was using their products. Think of Kodak. A lot of the companies that were around back in the tech boom of the late 1990s, little shadows of their former selves today. Right now, crypto is all the rage, but we know with history of financial markets that things come in and out of fashion.
And for all of us who are putting our hopes in crypto to help us get ahead, to help get a house in a brighter future.
Investing should really be a bit like watching grass grow, very slow. If you want to gamble, fair enough, go to Las Vegas or a casino and do that. You could put your money in Bitcoin and get really lucky, or another crypto, and it goes up in value. By the same token, it could collapse in value. It's very, very volatile. So you really need to go in with your eyes open. You really need to be very careful.
Coming up next week.
You've been scammed, plain and simple.
The wolves of crypto.
Well, I was panicking, my heart was like racing.
Taking everything.
20,000 Australian dollars, gone, disappeared.
Welcome to the wild, wild west.
This is crazy. I think my coins might have disappeared.
It's your trade, it's your money. You have to put your big pants on to play crypto.